Hello everybody and welcome to my full vlog of the Imagine Dragons Evolve Tour concert in Manchester Arena. I hope you enjoy it. Sorry about it being so long, but I've given you the taste of every song, basically. And I do a little vlog at the end, so I hope you enjoy it, guys. I really didn't think I was going to get to this concert. Looking back at it now, it's amazing. I'm sorry I can't condense it anymore. The set list will be in the description, as well as any other points that you need to visit. So I hope you all enjoy it. Wearing me, sport me new hoodie. Where is it? That side. There we go. Hope you enjoy it, guys. Hey guys, how's it going? This is the vlog you're expecting, but you're probably wondering why you haven't seen James yet. Or to cut a long story short, he basically can't be here right now because of the stupid fucking weather. You know, due to us having the what did they call it, like the coldest March on records, like ever. And it just happened to be the coldest March on records ever when Imagine Dragons happened to just have their concert. Oh my god, it was it was bullshit, basically. James can't come, basically, is what I'm trying to get at. James can't be here today, and he's absolutely fucking gutted. And it's just, it's this, I mean, there's still snow outside. You can still see remnants of Snowy Joey out there, but he's just kind of, he's just a snowy lump now. I don't know, but basically James can't be here today, but I'm still going to be vlogging. I'm still going to try and get as much footage as I can of like the journey and going to Manchester. By the way, I need to get a shower before I go. This is like, I don't know what that is. I'm up and about. I'm going today. I'm just going today with a friend instead of James. He can't be here. I've got two tickets, so I thought I may as well take somebody else. Yeah, me and James are probably obviously watching this right now, and I mean, I'm sorry that you can't be here, and it was just fucking badass luck that this happened to just be the coldest and snowiest March on records when we happened to go to a concert. Oh my god, I just can't believe it. Basically, all of the trains, all of the buses, all of the motorways that were getting him to here, all of them, like, cancelled, delayed. People on the news have been sat in the train for like 12 hours in the dark because the train shut down and it's too safe to get up. It's too unsafe to get up the train and shit like that. It's just, oh man, it's been an unbelievable few days. Like, since Wednesday, since the snow first came down, since I realized that James couldn't come, I just wanted it to piss off. I was just like, and now, I guarantee, the snow has melted. Since James can't come down, now that we found out that James can't come down, the snow is starting to melt. Like, you know, because that's what the world wants. The world's like, oh, no, fuck. We don't want James to come to this concert. Okay, the concert's been, now we'll all melt. Oh, fucking snow, 20 degrees. Oh, yeah, I guarantee it. It's like fucking Mexico out there tomorrow. I guarantee it after the concert's over. Pfft, telling you. But I'll still be going, I'll still be seeing Imagine Dragons, but it'll just be with my friend. I'll try and get as much footage as I possibly can. I'm just going to go and get like a shower and get sorted now. Then we're going to make the trip into Manchester. Hopefully, for fuck's sake, the trains are off. Oh my god, trains off, delayed. Seems to be the fucking pattern for the last few days. Unbelievably devastated that I can't, you know, enjoy it with James. Because we've been looking forward to this. We booked it in like November, October time, and it was just like, we've been looking forward to this for like, what, 4 or 5 months? I can't even be asked counting, but it's about that. Been looking forward to it for fucking months, basically. So yeah, I hope you enjoyed the vlog anyway. So I'll do my best to try and get as much footage as I can today. Okay, all's done and ready. Now I need to go and sort whatever the fuck this is out. I'm flying the flag, you know what I mean? Imagine Dragons, and I don't know if you can you see the dates? I don't know if you could probably see that. It's probably just like showing you a load of wall or something. But yeah, I'm gonna go and sort everything in my life, and a cup of tea wouldn't be nice. It fucking would be nice, I'm telling you right now. Shit. Fuck, that's hot.
Hey everybody, look, it's still Snowy Joey, kind of. It's what's left of him, you know. There's an eye, I think.
Got my ticket. Oh fuck.
PlayStation Remote just decided to commit suicide. Calm down, PlayStation. It's fine. I'll be coming back later. Don't worry, it's fine. I won't be in Manchester Arena forever. Calm yourself.
Yeah, I got time for some of the OG Rocket League. Supersonic Acrobatic Rocket Power Battle Cars. What? I don't even know what the acronym is, but I'll just say that. Supersonic Acrobatic Rocket Power Battle Cars. Woo!
What did I say to you? Oh, look at that. What's that magical thing on me? Oh, it's sun. It's heat. Oh, look. It's like fucking Mexico out there. It is two or three degrees. It's been minus one for like 5 days straight. Now the James can't get here. Day of the concert. Look, it's 3 degrees. Snowy Joey, hanging in there, just about, you know, he's down there, a little lump. He's like, oh, don't be snow friends are leaving me because they'll all get melted by the heat. God, anyway.
Got me old phone, got a battery pack, got a lead.
Got my actual phone with me, got the tickets, and I'm ready to fucking, you know, that way. Just, yeah. Okay, guys, coats on, got the tickets, and basically I'm ready to go. I don't think there's anything else. Got me tickets, got me phone, all that shit, yeah. Got the watch. So my train's in 10 minutes to get to Liverpool Central, to town, where I meet my mate, and then we're going to Manchester from there. So might not be able to talk as much because there's going to be people around, and I look like a weirdo talking to myself. But, yeah, I'll vlog, and I'll try. Oh, by the way, guys, thank you for all of the logo support. I've released it on Twitter. I recently did a logo, new logo for the channel. It took me a while to find out what I actually wanted. But yeah, I'm working on a YouTube banner over the next few weeks. I mean, I've got to work that in and around university and stuff. But yeah, just thanks for all your support for that, really. I really like it. It's a really cool logo. And I'm really happy that I like designed it myself, and it's all like woo, it's all like golden and superhero looking, as somebody said on Twitter. Looks like I'm some kind of superhero. Going to get the train. Hey guys. Oh, I've got a story to tell you, basically. We're stuck. Me and my mate are stuck in the middle. We basically got on the train at Lime Street, basically Liverpool main station, and we got halfway to Manchester in the middle of nowhere, and they said, oh, the train's stopping. We can't get on the train. The train is not going anywhere. It's ridiculous that the train didn't go anywhere, and oh my god, so basically we said, okay, yeah, we'll just go home, you know, cut our losses or whatever, see if there's another train from Liverpool Lime Street going in a different track to Manchester so we can still make the venue. Oh, but no, the track is suddenly broken on the other side, so now we can't even get back to Liverpool. Fuck's sake. Hopefully we might get there, and if not, I'll set a couple of losses and go the fuck home. Just had to go through security. Oh my god. Finally arrived. Oh my god, after a long taxi journey. I don't know if you could probably see, hang on. All down there is mayhem because of security. Oh my god. But we're in. I actually made it to go and see Imagine Dragons. Now I'm just gonna find the seat.
goes just pushing him out into the world to make him easier.
was always dangerous. ball man. Everybody praying for the end times. Everybody hoping they can be the one. But I was born to run, I was born for thee. That brings you that peace of mind, and I'm damned if I need it. This is a love song.
I'm sorry.
Manchester. I love this city. We'll be here as many times you'll have us throughout the years, I promise you that. Thank you for treating us like we were at home. Thank you for taking us in, giving us love, your attention, your hearts, your voices, your minds, your energy. It's the only magic that I know in this world. And every night when the road gets long, you bring life to me. So thank you. We are the lucky ones to be able to come out here. The weather, all these things, you guys still came. You spent your hard money to come out here. We don't take it for granted. Thank you for being here. Peace and love to all you, to every single one of you. May you be safe. May this year be incredible for you. Manchester strong. Coming straight to you from Vegas strong. I'ma say all the words inside my head.
The blood in my veins.
door.
Feel the wind, your hair. Feel the rush way up here. We're walking the wire.
just got home. I am dead. I am fucking dead. You have no idea the day I have had. I mean, it was such a fucking good end to the day, as you know, you've seen it all, but it was just a fucking great end to a ridiculously overly stressful day for no reason. We could have just got there. Why do we have to go through all of that shite just to get there? I mean, oh my God, it was an unbelievable show. I mean, Dan, fucking, oh my God, Dan Reynolds, he's just fucking, he's got an unbelievable voice and he's just unbelievably active on the stage and he just gets everyone involved. Best live shows, probably one of the best live artists. I mean, I haven't seen, you know, anyone else basically, but if he's not a good live artist, then I don't know who would be better than him. You know what I mean? I don't know who would be a good live artist if he isn't. Basically flying the flag for Dan and his boys. I got this today. You probably haven't realised that. I posted on Snapchat, if you added to me Snapchat. But basically got a hoodie. And I'm flying the flag again for Dan and his boys. But if I take this off...
Look at that, guys. I mean, it's... Maybe there was better ones, but I mean, that's just fucking awesome. Evolve, the Evolve tour. It was an unbelievable show. And I mean, the fucking... Oh my God. Just, they are unbelievable. And there's the logo as well, like the, well, it's kind of the guy falling, that's kind of the thing. I took a battery pack with me, you know, in case we fucking ran out of battery, which we eventually almost did, because I've recorded, like, the entire concert. I've basically, like, kind of recorded the entire concert, almost. And I don't know, I mean, I apologise for the footage, because it's so hard to film with a steady hand when you're fucking bouncing up and down to these bad boys. Unbelievable. It's just, it's one of the best. It was better than Smoke and Mirrors. I went to see the Smoke and Mirrors tour as well. And they did so many more old songs. They did so much more old material, as well as mixing it in with the new material. The transitions from doing a newer song from the album over into some... Like, they transitioned over into, like, Believer or some random, like, Dream and all that. They started, like, putting all the old ones on and everyone was like, oh, fucking yes, I know this, and started, like, fucking bouncing to them. I've basically tried my best to condense this down. This might end up be, like, almost... This will be past half an hour, this vlog. It must be. Because the amount of footage I recorded there tonight, I'm going to literally give you a taste of all of the songs. I'm going to put the names of the songs... what album they're from, just basically, like, the names of the artists and all that stuff, and basically, if you guys ever want to go, or I know there's a few people out there on my Snapchat that I was talking to tonight, that say they really want to fucking go and enjoy these things, and it's, like, on the to-do list, or the bucket list, or whatever, if you ever want to go, and if I can somehow help you make a decision to actually go and spend hard-earned money on this band, honest to God, unbelievably 100% worth it. I just do it. Just it might be different. It might be different in a vlog, but if that concert can't convince anyone that they are one of the best live artists in the world, then unbelievable. I mean, they are bucket list to see. Possibly just under Linkin Park, and I was just about to see Linkin Park before Chester Bennington unfortunately passed away. Linkin Park were one of the top, but like, I was listening to them since Minutes of Midnight came out, and I think I was like, I was in my teens. I was in like early teens. I was in like 14, 15, maybe even earlier than that, I don't know. But I was listening to Linkin Park in my early teens, definitely. Meteora and all that type of thing. They're like the big band I wanted to see. Then Imagine Dragons kind of crept in. I heard Radioactive. I was like, fucking yes. Who are these people? I mean, you already know I've done this, but I haven't edited this yet. So what I'm going to do is I'm going to go through each of the songs. I'm going to try and fade them in and out of each other. Put the names of the songs and the album and whatever on each of the things. Every time a new song comes on, I'll tell you which one.
And basically that's it. You can see which song it is, how it sounds live, how Dan actually sounds live. Dan Reynolds is unbelievable live. He can actually sing, unlike some artists. I mean, some artists I've heard, people go to see them and they're like, yeah, they can't sing. It's all auto-tune. Like, they can't do it. But Dan, you go out and literally the believer and radioactive notes that he has to hit in the studio, he still fucking, and other songs as well, he still fucking hits them every time. He goes for it and he's there. He's just, he was on fire tonight. He really was on fire tonight though. And I mean, guys, I'll be honest, I really didn't think I was going to be showing you that footage tonight. I really didn't think I was going to get there. I mean, I'll condense this down. It's half 12 right now. I have literally just got back. It's half 12. I'm fucked. I'm hungry for a start. I want a cup of tea, which I need to go and make. Just thank you all so much for watching this video, and I'm glad you stuck with me throughout the journey. I really didn't think I couldn't get home or to the concert. There was no chance of me getting there or back. I was like, we got on a train at Lime Street. I'm sorry, my voice is completely gone. I'm going to wake up tomorrow morning and I'll have no voice. But yeah, he's inspirational. He has these inspirational speeches that everybody should listen to and take advice from. He suffered with depression for years in his life and now look where he is. And it's just, he gives a lot of life messages in his concerts. He gives wisdom as well as a decent performance and a decent time, a good night. It's just, he's one of the best live I've seen anyway. I mean, he's the only live I've seen, so I can't really say anything. But I'm going to guess, from what I've seen, that is how a live performance should be. You know what I mean? If you know the songs and you are a fan of them, that is how something should be performed live, basically, is what I'm saying. So yeah, I'm going to give you a really, really quick rundown because it's half 12. I need to have a cup of tea and go to bed and just die because I've got all this to edit tomorrow. So I'm going to give you a quick rundown. Right, first of all, we got on the train in the centre of Liverpool, Lime Street, to Manchester, right, which was the little bit of the vlog on the train that I showed you. Then there was nothing after that. It just turned into me. The next clip was me in Newton Le Willows in St. Helens, fucking in the middle of nowhere, like, stuck. The train stopped and said, awfully sorry, you'll have to make your own way somewhere. There might be a rail replacement bus service. You don't know, you might just have to take a chance, you know. So they said, there's a train to Lime Street. You can go back to Lime Street, back home, and then you can come back and go in a different track to Manchester. So we go, okay, we'll go home then. We go over to the other platform. The train is cancelled because the track going from Manchester to where we are to take us back home, yes, it's a mind fuck, just stay with me, was broken. So that meant we couldn't get there. We couldn't get home. We were fucked. So basically, what we ended up doing was phoning my dad and being like, can you come and get us and all that stuff? Could you take us there and we'll try and find a way home and all that stuff? But basically, we ended up coming to the conclusion that we had to take a 40, almost, it was 35-ish, £36 taxi from Newton Le Willows, from a Mackey's. We went over to a Tesco, found out the local cab company and rang them up, got a fucking cab from there all the way to the arena, got there, the doors opened at 6, we got there at like, I want to say about 7, quarter past 7 we got there, K-Play, that's it, not K-Play, I nearly forgot her name then, there was a band called K-Play, I don't know if they're a band, or if the woman is called K-Play, because she said my name is K-Play, but she was with a drummer, a guitarist and all that. So I don't know whether they're a band or just she's called K-Flay and she had a little sporting act that I don't know how it works. But basically K-Flay, if you've ever heard of K-Flay, she's kind of similar, rocky, heavy metal-y type of headbanging style. Some of the songs, I mean, one of the songs I did recognise, I think one of the songs was on FIFA 18. I think it was either FIFA 18 or FIFA 17. One of the songs anyway was. Bottom line, if you have a chance, if Imagine Dragons are still on tour and there's tickets available, get your ass online right now. See if they are coming to you in America, wherever you are. I think they're going to America. They're going to... They've still got loads of fucking countries to go to.
if you're seeing this and you want to go and see them, check if they're going to your country and fucking go. Just go. What are you watching this for? Just go. But don't go when there's snow and the fucking weather and breaks the tracks and the strikes on the trains and literally it's like fucking Indiana Jones 3 trying to get the Holy Grail to actually just get to Manchester in the first place. Oh my god, I've never had so much trouble trying to get to one destination in my life. I hope the vlog isn't too long. I'll try and cut it down as much as possible. I just wanted to get the most amount of footage I possibly could get to you guys there. I wanted to get the most amount of, like, concert footage there. You know what I mean? James, obviously, unbelievably gutted that he couldn't be there, mate. I mean, honest to fucking God, we would have bounced. And I am honestly joking. We would have hit the ceiling and then hit the floor and then repeat. We would have fucking... Oh my God, they came back on. They went off. Everyone thought they left. They ran back on and started banging the fucking drum when they were playing Radioactive. Oh my God, the place just... We are going. We will fucking go. They said... Now, don't know if this is mean a new album's coming or whether they're doing the same tour again, but they said, see you next year. Now, I don't know what that means. But maybe that's a hint at a new album. I love the fact that thousands, seeing all them thousands, maybe... Yeah, thousands, maybe possibly verging on hundreds of thousands of people today there. Just seeing them all come together for one cause is exactly what I want to do with this channel. You all come to this channel for the one cause, to watch what I put out, and it's kind of the same aspect. I mean, I'm no fucking Dan, I'm not Imagine Dragons. Fuck me, I wish I was. I will try my best to bring people together like they bring people together and just... do charities and charity work and all that stuff, and I just hope that I can bring stuff to the world like they bring joy to people. They've just brought joy to hundreds of thousands. I don't know how big the MEN arena is. Maybe it's less than 100,000, but thousands anyway. Fucking loads of people, okay? More than one. Basically, I just hope I can bring that much happiness to you guys in the future. One little thing, I promise, one little thing and this will be over. It's probably like an hour long, I promise. Me and my dad are going to Comic-Con. No idea where it is, I forgot. No idea where it is, no idea what date, no idea what time. But apparently we've got some kind of passes that mean we get in there early-ish. So we're the first, one of the first ones walking around, I don't know. But basically, yeah, going to Comic-Con. We'll be vlogging it, you're coming with me. All you guys, I'm dragging you to Comic-Con. Again, you can see what Comic-Con's like if you ever want to go to a Comic-Con, or if you've ever been to a Comic-Con and you go into this one. I keep saying Comic-Con. Comic-Con. Oh, I went off the track there, didn't I? I really did. I've talked way too much. I've had a fucker of a day and a fucking outstanding night. Thank you all for enduring it with me. And go see Imagine Dragons. They're amazing. See you all in the next video.